Hello, welcome once again to Talking Drum. We're here for a second day at Musicport Festival, which is a world music festival. Yesterday, I interviewed you on the beach. I happened upon you on the beach playing a balafon, and we got talking. We did a fantastic interview, and then it turned out that you also play spoons, and the spoons workshop that I was planning to come to today, and I was really excited about most of the weekend. It turned out you were running it. Tell us about spoons as a musical instrument and not a culinary implement. That's all right. There's some people enjoying the festival so much they're cheering and shouting, probably about the spoons workshop that they missed. They're complaining because they missed the spoons workshop.
Can we cut that bit?
We can cut that bit, yes. We'll cut that bit. Or I'll leave bits. We'll see.
What did you say? Tell me about spoon playing.
Yes.
Into spoon playing about probably 8 years ago or something. I was playing with a band and we were doing a song which just for some reason seemed to be calling out for spoons. I'm not really sure why. It's quite a jolly tune. And I thought, I thought it would be a great thing to learn. They're very portable, great fun to play. So I started off learning from a video by a guy called David Holt. He's an American guy, he's a fantastic musician. And I just had an introductory sort of video of his, and I learnt some stuff from there. And went from there, really. I just love playing them. They're just such great fun, makes people smile.
Now, they are fun. This is a controversial... I like to be controversial, I like to challenge. Are they a real musical instrument?
Of course they are. People used to play them years ago. I don't know how far back it goes, but I think it goes back quite a long time. And I think it's something that's died sort of recently, more recently. But I'm trying to bring it back because I think everyone should play the spoons.
I just did a workshop with you and I really enjoyed it. The thing that got me, and it's something that I couldn't believe how expressive they are as a musical instrument. In theory, you're getting a pair of spoons and you're hitting them against your leg and you're hitting them against your hand. How does that expressiveness in terms of tone come out?
I mean, you can get different sounds depending on how you hit your leg. For example, I'll show you.
Oh, we've got some handy spoons here.
Yep. Okay. For example, if you tap your leg just with the tip of the spoon, you get a very light sound. If you use the whole spoon, you get more of an accented, heavy sound. So one of the rhythms that I play a lot is this rhythm. With a lot of music. So what I usually do is put the accents in like this. So you can hear the different tones, which is very different to just doing that kind of thing, yeah. Which I didn't go into in the workshop, but that is, yeah.
Because I was wondering, because I saw you did a brief performance before we started while we were waiting for people to turn up, and that was the thing that suddenly struck me. I've seen people play spoons before, and it's normally things like, you know, something from the 1970s of some family that all play wooden kitchen spoons together.
Right.
And it's kind of shown as an example of how bad TV was in the 70s. And then I saw you playing and I thought, this is a real musical instrument and I can't believe that people aren't playing them more. Now, you had a variety of... Well, for a start, I thought you had probably like 1,000 sets of spoons there. But you had spoons of different types as well. Yeah. So does that make a difference in tone as well?
Oh, of course, yes. I mean, these are actually my favourite spoons to play myself. I use them a lot. Another pair that I use a lot, just because I like them, are these, which came from my mum and dad's cutlery drawer. So I really love the sound of them. And there are also, if you sort of root around in cutlery drawers, sometimes you find some that ring on a bit more as well. These don't ring that much, but some actually, they give a really good ring. Some of the others that I use in the workshops are these, which are really good for beginners.
Oh, is that the ones with the groove in the middle?
With the groove.
Yeah, my fingers start to hurt quite early on, and I moved to those, and I did find it a bit more of a relief. Yeah.
Not everybody finds these easier, but a lot of people find them easier just because they've got the hole for your finger. So you put your first finger through that hole, thumb on the top, three fingers underneath. And I think sometimes if you haven't got that hole, you know, your hand slides around a bit more and it's harder to grip. So I use these. These are very popular. These are some of the ones that I use with younger children in with special needs groups, joined up spoons. So all you have to do is hold on to the blue handle. I've also got some wooden ones a little bit like that as well. These are my latest acquisition, which came from a kitchen shop. Came in a set of four. These are the smallest ones. Unfortunately, they wouldn't sell me them separately. So I now have a lot of very large spoons as well.
So I do tend to embarrass the family because obviously the entire world is a potential musical instrument, I think, if you're a percussionist.
Definitely.
So when you go into a hardware store or a kitchen store, are you the kind of person that is tapping things and thinking, should I be buying this as a musical instrument?
I do sometimes, yeah. I tend to head for the spoons more than anything else, but I'm always keeping an eye out for...
And can you get friends and family to come with you shopping, or is that a problem because of the fact that you start doing things like that? Or are they used to it by now?
I think they're used to it. I mean, I suppose I tend to root around in kitchen shops when I'm by myself.
Right.
But yeah.
I think resigned is the way that I could describe my family when we go shopping.
I think people are used to my spoons craze.
So here's the thing that I can get very kind of, I'd like to say deconstructionist, but probably geeky is probably the word. As soon as I saw you playing, the thing that went through my head was, are these some kind of a beta and your body the musical instrument, or are they a percussion instrument and your body is the thing that's playing them? How does it fit into the way that you think of more, not conventional, but other types of percussion instruments?
That's a very good question. I mean, I suppose if you're playing drums with sticks, you're playing you've got an actual drum and you're holding the sticks and you play with the sticks. I suppose in some ways it's similar to that, isn't it?
But your thigh is there.
My thigh is like the drum, I suppose, in a way. But I mean, you need the spoons and you need your body. So I mean, I suppose for me, it's all part of the instrument, really.
And just in case people thought I wasn't geeky enough, let's say it's symbiotic. So there are some instruments that we have as percussionists that I always think you could describe them as being efficient. You could be describing them as having kind of cheat codes. One of them is shaker, where if you play your shaker, you're playing backwards and forwards. Mm-hmm. So as if you were hitting a stick, you would get beats that only happen when you go forwards.
Yeah.
When you play a shaker, you get beats both ways, or you get sounds both ways. There was a bit of that with your technique with the percussion, and also a technique that I reminded me of tambourine players when they play the tambourines in samba bands.
Okay.
Where when you're lifting the stick up, you're turning the drum over so that you hit it down.
That's
on one side, back
it's
on the other.
It's very similar. What we were doing earlier is very
similar. And
yeah.
So show us a bit of that.
That kind of thing. But you could actually play it a little bit like the samba sort of style. It's a bit like that, isn't it? That kind of feel to it. So yeah, you could do the same thing but change the feel and get that kind of groove going. Yeah.
And that's, I think, what I enjoy, and this is why I'm going to recommend everybody out there to start learning to play spoons if you're a percussionist, is... It's a much more expressive instrument than even hand drums because of the way you hold your hands, the way you create a cup against the cup of the spoon, and the way you hit it against your thigh, and also the way that you can get quite sophisticated rhythms because you're getting offbeats and upbeats by literally lifting your spoon hand up, and then the way that you're using your hand. So I noticed that you've, like I said, you've got about 1,000 sets of spoons in your workshop set. How long is it going to be before we, and hopefully you're going to invite me along to this, before we have the performance of the world's biggest spoons orchestra?
Well, I think we need to get organising, don't we? Yeah, I'd definitely love to do something like that. Flash mob, I think, would be good.
I think at the World Drumming Network, we're going to be in touch.
That would be great. Brilliant. Amazing. I'd love to do a massive one. The biggest workshop I've done, I think, so far was at Towersey Festival. I've done a few spoons workshops in the church there, which is quite interesting. And we've had about 120 people in there, which has been brilliant. Right. But, yeah, to do a really big group, that would be amazing.
So let's hope next time we see you, it's because we're filming you and we're involved, because we're spoon percussion. There'll be spoon percussionists and they'll be in their hundreds.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Brilliant. Thank you very much, Joe.
Thank you.